Chairman Henry Waxman, who began holding hearings on AIDS in 1982, before there was even a name for AIDS, was leading here in Washington to make sure that this got the informed attention that it deserved, and who led the House in passing the original Ryan White legislation.
Henry Waxman has been a leader. He's been a conscience of the nation around public health issues in general, but HIV in particular. And it's hard to imagine how we would have dealt with this epidemic without having Henry Waxman as chair of the Health Subcommittee in the early years and then chair of the Energy and Commerce Committee. He had on his committee some people who held very bizarre beliefs about how HIV was transmitted. And he used those committee hearings as a way to debunk a lot of the myths around HIV, as well as to push policy forward. That's a very difficult balancing act.
In the early days of the epidemic, when really no one really knew what was causing this disease, the first thing we really needed to do was to be able to figure out where it was and how it was spreading and many important things before there was even a test for HIV antibodies. Representative Waxman was very influential in helping the CDC get funding, I remember around $5 million, to help do surveillance, to really see where the epidemic was starting, how it was spreading, better help us understand how blood transfusions, mother to child transmission were all involved, and that really mapped out what we're going to be dealing with in years to come.
There was no way we would get to know what this epidemic was all about, how to treat it, how to eventually even think about curing it without adequate funds being available. And he really took on the charge to make sure that Congress approved dedicated funding for research in HIV/AIDS. He's also been a tireless advocate for ensuring that the integrity of research and its translation into policy is maintained.
During the entirety of the 80s, we went through roller coasters in which the public and the press were either apathetic, couldn't care less about AIDS, or were panicked and wanted to quarantine everyone. So trying to find that middle ground of urgency that was neither panic nor apathy was, I think, his strongest commitment throughout the early 80s.
We cannot shortchange the epidemic. It is threatening the lives of hundreds of thousands of Americans. It's threatening the solvency of our public health system.
What's particularly compelling about HIV is that it tends to occur to highly stigmatized populations. So his support of gay and lesbian civil rights legislation, even though it hasn't become law, that became linked with the fight against AIDS. His support for the Americans with Disabilities Act, which was a critical component for assuring that all people with HIV and AIDS would be protected from discrimination. Again, he played a role in that effort as well.
In the mid-80s, Henry did a number of news interviews. One of them was a television news interview from a California television station. And she surprised me at the end of it by asking him a question that she had never mentioned to me, which is, isn't it true, Mr. Waxman, that you're working on AIDS issues because you represent West Hollywood, which is a gay ghetto? And Henry paused and he said, no, first of all, I work on this because I'm the chair of the committee that deals with public health, and this is an emerging public health issue. Secondly, would it be so bad if I did work on AIDS for that reason? You don't really question when a Pennsylvania congressman works on steel issues because he has steel workers in his district. And third, I work on AIDS because, in a larger sense, because I'm a Jew and I know what it's like for a society not to care if you live or die.
While we had to create a separate program like Ryan White to address the needs of people with HIV, simultaneously he was pushing to make sure that the existing system, like the Medicaid system, really was responsive to the needs of people with HIV. And so, you know, health reform is actually the culmination of that effort.
I've worked off and on with him for 30 years now, and I can't think of anybody who measures up to him as a shrewd politician, but also as a really pragmatic and creative thinker about how to put laws together. I just admire him very much.
We obviously need continued leadership from people like Henry Waxman, and Henry Waxman in particular, because he carries the history of this issue and knows it probably as well as any of his staff, and you can't say that for many members of Congress.
There's no one in Congress that comes even close to what he has done. He definitely played the star role. We are so honored to present the third C. Everett Koop HIV AIDS Public Health Leadership Award to Congressman Henry Waxman.